Tonight, I'm gonna have myself. Freddie Mercury was born Farrokh Bulsara on September 5, 1945 in the British Protectorate of Zanzibar, East Africa, which is now a part of Tanzania. Freddie spent most of his childhood in India at a boarding school while his family continued to live in Zanzibar. He began taking piano lessons at 7 years of age. When he was 8, he left home to attend St. Peter's School, a British-style boarding school in Mumbai, then Bombay. Freddie and his family fled from Zanzibar in the 1964 Zanzibar Revolution. The family moved to Feltham, Middlesex, England, and Freddie enrolled in college in West London. There, he joined a jazz band. At a gig with his band, he met Roger Taylor and Brian May, who had a band called Smile. Eventually, together, they formed the band Queen. And the rest, as they say, is history. EMI Records and Elektra Records signed the band in 1971. Their debut album, Queen, was hailed by critics as one of the most exciting developments in rock. Queen's single, Bohemian Rhapsody, was released in 1975 and was on the British top 40 charts for 9 weeks straight. Soon, their fame extended past England and America, verging into Europe and Japan with their hit A Crazy Little Thing Called Love. Queen quickly became a huge sensation, touring all over the world for sold-out shows and performing over 700 concerts. Queen became well-known for their large-scale live performances, promoting Freddie to note, "We're the Cecil B. DeMille of rock and roll." In 1985, Queen performed at Live Aid to a stadium audience of 72,000 people who clapped, danced, and sang in unison. This performance was later voted by music executives as the greatest live performance in the history of rock music. In the mid-80s, Freddie decided to start working on a solo career, though he never left Queen. Freddie did many other things in his solo career, including working on stage in dramatic productions and in musical theater. Freddie's final live performance with Queen was in 1986 in the Knebworth Park in England. The concert was estimated to have been attended by as many as 300,000 people. Freddie's struggle against AIDS ended with his death in 1991, a mere 24 hours after he announced that he had the disease. Freddie is remembered for his extensive influence in music, his theatrical style. But Freddie is also remembered by many statues in his honor all around the world, including one overlooking Lake Geneva in Montreux, Switzerland. Every September 5th, people of the world are encouraged to dress up like Freddie in an effort to celebrate Freddie's life and help fight HIV/AIDS. Also, Freddie is remembered on the internet and has become an internet meme. One of Freddie's major obstacles was his bisexuality, or so after homosexual marriage had become legal in England. I think Freddie Mercury is a hero because he was one of the very first out gay celebrities, and he was one of the first celebrity gay advocates.